Hey, this is Ben at Harrison. I just want to demonstrate some of the new features we've added to support the PreSonus fader port control surface. This is a little one fader controller that you use to control one channel of your workstation and basic transport and window features. It's pretty cool, inexpensive, and works great with MixBus. Let me demonstrate how to get this hooked up. Of course, the first thing you'll do is plug the USB cable from the fader port into your Mac or Windows computer. And then we open the preferences window. And I'm going to switch over to the Control Surfaces tab. And you see I have four different choices for Control Surface Protocol. So we want to make sure the fader port is enabled. And then we'll double click on it. And we choose incoming MIDI on the fader port MIDI port. That shows up named via the USB connection. And then we have a lot of customizable features that we can apply to the fader port. I'll return to that in a few minutes. Right now, let's just check and see if it's working. Let's see if I move my fader. Yeah, you can see that I've got one channel selected red. And if I click on another channel to select it, then that becomes red and the fader moves to match and I can move the fader. And I can use the channel select buttons on the fader port to select which channel gets turned red. And then, of course, I can pan the channel left and right using the knob. I can mute and solo the channel, and record arm the channel. If I hold down shift, I can adjust the input trim for the channel, which is a cool feature. And then I have control of the fader automation, so I can drop it into read so it plays back automation, or write so that I'm writing automation, or touch so that it writes automation when I touch the fader and the transport is rolling. And then we have our basic transport controls across the bottom, so I'm going to switch over to the editor page. And now if I press play, then of course we play. And I can rewind. And each successive time I press the rewind or fast forward button, it plays faster and faster, either forward or reverse. And then I have the master record arm so I can punch in and out. You can also trigger that from the foot switch. We've got several controls in the transport that respond to the shift key, so if I hold shift and press the rewind, then it jumps me to the start of the session. Or I can hold shift and jump to the end of the session. I can hold shift and jump to the previous marker or the next marker. And if I'm rolling the transport, I can drop a new marker by holding shift and pressing loop. And now that I've created that marker, if I want to undo that, I can press the undo button. Or shift and undo will redo that marker. And now I have some window view buttons. And these are customizable, so they don't do anything right now. But if I switch back to my control panel page, you see that I can select different actions for each of these buttons. So I'm going to choose on the mix window, now mix button, I'm going to choose to show and hide the mixer window. So now when I press that button, I toggle between the editor and mix windows in the background. The project button, I like to set it up to show the meter bridge so that I can monitor my input meters. I can hide and show that window. And the transport button, I use to toggle the metronome on and off. And then there's a user button, and this one can be assigned to any feature that you can choose in the MixBus menus. So there are hundreds and hundreds of different actions you can trigger with that. One of the ones that I've used it for in the past is to start and finish ranges, editing range. But you can experiment with those, and there are also variants of these buttons when you hold the shift key or if you hold them for a long time. So it's a very rich implementation of features for this little fader port controller. You can really get a lot done with this little guy. It's inexpensive, works great with MixBus. It's certainly an option to consider if you're looking for a hardware controller.